So here we have a problem number 1. If the normal to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax at point 80 square 280 cuts the parabola again at 80, a capital T square 280, then what should be the sum values of t which are given in option. So we have the equation of normal. At point 80 square 280 as y plus tx is equal to 280 plus 80 cube, right? This is the equation of normal at point 80 square 280. So this line also passes through this point, right? Because this normal cuts the parabola again at this point. That means AT square, A capital T square to A capital T. So this, the equation of this straight line must satisfy the point AT square to AT. So we have in place of Y 280 plus T in place of X AT square is equal to 280 plus 80 cube. Okay. Or we can write it as 2a t minus small t, taking this side, is equal to 80 cube minus t a t square. Okay. Or we can have 2a t minus t is equal to, taking a t square as common, so t minus you cannot take t square, you have to take a t as common, so t square minus capital T square, okay, is equal to a t t minus capital T t plus capital T. Or taking this AT T minus capital T T cup plus capital T minus 2A or plus 2A T minus capital T is equal to 0. Or we have taking A T minus capital T as common, we will be getting T T plus capital T plus 2 is equal to 0. Or we have a t minus t, then t square plus t times t plus 2 is equal to 0. Say here either small t is equal to t or this equation is equal to 0, right? This cannot be possible. This is not possible because these are two points. AT square, AT square 280 small t and a capital T square 280. I mean AT square 280 and AT square 280 are two different points. So T cannot be equal to T. So there is only one option left, that is T square plus TT plus 2 should be equal to 0, right? So this equation has real solutions, right? Okay. Why? Because these both T and T are real. Okay. So we have discriminant of this equation greater than 0. So D must be greater than 0, equal to 0, greater than equal to 0. So D is B square minus 4AC. So T square minus 4 into 2 must be greater than or equal to 0, or T square must be greater than or equal to A. So we have a relation T square greater than or equal to 8, which is satisfied by option A. So option A is correct. Moving towards the next question. If B and C are the lengths of the segments of any focal chord of a parabola, then the length of the semi lapidus rectum is. See, what the question is asking is, say this is a parabola, okay, and this is its focus. So lapidus rectum is this line. This is perpendicular to axis and passing through focus. So this is lapidus rectum. So this is the length of semi lapidus rectum, right? Okay. This is the length of semi lapidus rectum, isn't it? So this point, say this point is P. Its coordinate is A0. So its coordinate must be AT square 280. Means y square is equal to 4x. So A and 2A, right? So this length must be 2A. So length of semi lapidus rectum is 2A. Suppose there are two focal cords. Okay. So this is a focal cord. Okay. And its length is given as B, right? And there is another focal cord. Say this is another focal cord. This length is given as C. This length is B and this length is C, right? So what is the length of lapidus rectum, right? This is asking length of lapidus rectum. So as you can see, this lapidus rectum, okay, is harmonic mean between these segments. So we can write the length of this semi lapidus rectum as, we can write lapidus rectum, here lapidus rectum is harmonic mean between the segments, right? So length of lapidus rectum must be, semi lapidus rectum, because semi lapidus rectum is the harmonic mean between the segments. So length of semi lapidus rectum must be equal to harmonic mean of B and C, which is 2 by 1 by B plus 1 by C equal to 2BC by B plus C, right? So from here, option B is correct. Now moving to the next question. The equation of tangent at the vertex of a parabola is, so here we have to find the vertex of this parabola. First, the equation of parabola is x square plus 4x plus 2y is equal to 0. So the step one is here to get this equation in standard form. So let us convert this equation in standard form. So our equation, we can write this equation as 2y is equal to minus of x square plus 4x, right? Or further, y is equal to minus half x square plus 4x, right? Y is equal to minus half. We can make it as a perfect square, like x square plus 4x plus 2 square, and then we have, since added 2 square, we have to subtract 2 square, right? Which means minus half x plus 2 square, okay, plus 2 times 4, 4 divided by 2, 2, right? Or we can write it as y माइनस टू इज इक्वल टू माइनस हाफ x प्लस टू स्क्वायर इक्वल टू इन टर्म्स ऑफ 4ax देन माइनस 4 इंटू 1 बाई फोर इंटू 1 बाई 8 एक्स प्लस टू स्क्वायर. सो आवर इक्वेशन इन स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म इज y माइनस टू इज इक्वल टू माइनस 4 1 बाई 8 एक्स प्लस टू स्क्वायर. सो व्हाट आवर वर्टेक्स इज वर्टेक्स ऑफ पैराबोला इज माइनस 2 एंड 2 राइट इट्स समथिंग लाइक दिस. द वर्टेक्स इज माइनस 2 x is equal to minus 2 and y is equal to 2. Here the vertex is, right? And the axis is, this is the axis and the parabola is of this type. y square is equal to minus 4x. So the parabola is like this, right? So we have tangent at what? Tangent at, so the question is asking tangent at vertex. So tangent at vertex is, must be this tangent, that is line x is equal to minus 2. Okay, so we have option A as correct option. We are now moving to the next question. The coordinates of a point on parabola y square is equal to 8x, which is minimum distance from circle x square plus y minus 6 square is equal to 1. Okay, so we have a parabola y square is equal to 8x and we have a circle x square plus y minus 6 square is equal to 1 and we have to find the minimum distance between these two curves. Okay, so first see, if these two curves intersect each other, then minimum distance between these two curves is 0. Right, isn't it? If these two curves intersect, that is the parabola and circle intersect, then the distance between these two curves must be 0. But if these two curves does not intersect, then there must be some minimum distance between these two curves which we have to find in this case. So the situation is something like this. We have a parabola y square is equal to 8x and a circle which is inside this parabola, where say its focus is 4ax, 2 0 2 0 is its focus, and center of circle is 0 6, somewhat here say 0 6. So circle is like this. Okay, there is a parabola and there is a circle and these are not intersecting, it is clear. So you have a some minimum distance like this. This distance is a minimum distance, this is a minimum distance. So you have to find this distance which is minimum. Okay, right? So if you see, say this is a parabola and say this is a circle. Okay, the center is 0 6 and radius is 1 and its focus is 2 0. So the minimum distance between this circle and this parabola is distance between, if you notice one thing, distance between tangents, parallel tangents, right? Distance between its parallel tangents, right? Which is, say, we draw tangent at the point which is minimum distance between these two curves. So let us denote this point as A and point on parabola as B. So since AB is minimum, B minimum is the length AB, and we draw a tangent at point A on circle. Say this tangent is T1 and this tangent is T2. So T1 is tangent as is tangent at A and T2 is at A on circle, right? Because A is a point on circle and T2 is tangent at tangent at B on parabola. So one thing you should notice that the distance between these two tangents is the minimum distance. So if you can find the equation of these two tangents, okay, so we can easily find the distance between these two tangents, and hence we will be getting the minimum distance. Distance between these tangents, okay, is the minimum, right? This distance, that is. So let us write the equation of tangent in slope form on parabola at point B. So we have equation of tangent as, the equation of the curve is y square is equal to 4ax. So we have dy upon dx as let us write the tangent in slope form. So the equation of tangent in slope form is y is equal to mx plus y is equal to mx mx plus a by m, right? This is equation of tangent in slope form, right? Y is equal to mx plus c, c is equal to a by m is the condition that the tangent is on parabola. So we have tangent y is equal to mx plus a, in place of a, our, the equation of our parabola is 8x. So a is 2, 2 by m. Now this equation, this is also this equation, m is the slope, right? So the same slope, t1, the tangent t1 has also the same slope. So equation of tangent t1 can be written as, y is equal to mx plus some c, right? Okay, and we have to satisfy this equation c so that this lies on the circle, isn't it? So we have the equation as, say this is a circle and say here is a tangent. Okay, zero, 6, and its radius is 1 1. So the condition that x square plus y square is equal to a square, circle is a, and at line y is equal to mx plus c is a tangent. So what is the condition? The here the condition is c square is equal to a square m square plus a square, right? So if the circle changes like this, if the circle changes to x square plus y minus 6 square is equal to 1, then the equation of tangent also changes in the same order, that is y minus 6 is equal to mx plus c, right? Is a tangent to this circle. So here the condition is c square is equal to a square, which is 1, m square plus 1, right? Or we can write c is equal to 1 plus m square plus minus, right? So the equation of tangent is y is equal to mx plus 6 plus minus m square plus 1, okay? So we have two tangents possible. So since we are finding the closest distance, so we will be considering only one tangent, which is equal to this, right? One is closest distance and other is the maximum distance. So we are considering the closest distance, so we will be considering only one of the tangents out of them, right? So we have the equation of tangent on circle like this, right? Now we can also go through like this. Say this is our parabola, y square is equal to 8x, and say this is our circle. So at minimum distance, this line must be normal, okay, on both circle as well as parabola. So let us write the equation of normal on the parabola. So the equation of normal can be written as at point AT square to AT as y is y plus Px is equal to see, we have already written the equation of tangent at point T1, T2 on parabola. So the equation is y plus Tx is equal to 280 plus AT cube, right? So this is the equation of normal at point AT square 280. Y plus Tx is equal to 280 plus AT cube. So we will be writing the same equation here. Y plus Tx is equal to 80 square, 80 cube plus 280. Right? So here A is 2. So we have equation Y plus 2T is equal to 80 cube. 80 cube, that means, which means 2T cube plus 4t, right? So this equation passes through the center of the circle because this is passes through to center of circle. Why? Because this is normal to the circle also. So center of circle is 0, 6. So this equation satisfy the point 0, 6. So we have in place of y we can write 6 plus, this is x, right? Y plus xt, okay, is equal to 0, 2t cube, 2t cube plus 4t, okay. Or from here, we have 2t as common, t square plus 2q plus 2t is equal to 3. So from here one can easily say that t is equal to 1 is a solution, right? And other two solutions are complex. So t is equal to 1 is a real solution of this equation. So we have point of contact as two and four, because 280 is 4, so 2 and 4 is the point of contact. And the equation of tangent is, I mean, the equation of this line normal is y is equal to tx. Tx in place of tx, we can write t is equal to 1. Then y plus x is equal to, in place of t we can write 1, so 2 plus 4, 6. So this is the equation of normal, right? Now we have to find the point of contact of this normal on the circle, right? So now this is easy case. Say the point of contact of normal, the equation of normal at point, we have already written the equation of normal at any point on the circle, or in the form of, say, if the slope of the normal is m, then we can write the equation of the normal, or in terms of parametric form, that is a sin theta b cos theta, right? If the point on the circle is a cos theta b, in case of circle, if the point of contact is a cos theta a sin theta, right? Here a is 1, so we have point of contact as, say, cos theta sin theta, right? Then equation of tangent at that point can be written as, the equation of tangent, we have already written the equation of tangent on a circle at this point of contact, as x cos theta plus बी साइन थीटा से फॉर अ सर्कल एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर एट पॉइंट एक्स वन वाई वन द इक्वेशन ऑफ टेंजेंट इज रिटन एज एक्स एक्स वन अपॉन एक्स एक्स वन प्लस वाई वाई वन इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर राइट सो हियर वी हैव द पॉइंट कॉस ऑफ साइन थीटा सो वी कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यूज एंड फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ करस्पॉन्डिंग थीटा एंड सो वी कैन गेट द पॉइंट राइट बट सिंस वी हैव टू फाइंड द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन सो इट इज वेरी इजी यू सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस इक्वेशन ऑन द सर्कल एंड यू विल बी गेटिंग द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन सो द इक्वेशन ऑफ सर्कल इज x square plus y minus 6 square is equal to 1. So, in place of y minus 6, one can substitute minus x, right? From the equation of this line. Okay. From the equation of this line. So, if you substitute that, then we will be getting x square plus x square, that is 2x square is equal to 1, right? And x square is equal to half, so x is equal to 1 by root 2. Right? And correspondingly y is equal to plus or minus. And correspondingly y is equal to 6 minus plus 1 by root 2. Right? Okay? So we have the distance between those two points. Minimum distance between those two points. Is the point on parabola is 2, 4 and point on circle is plus minus 1 by root 2 and 6 plus minus 1 by 6 minus plus 1 by root 2, right? 6 minus plus 1 by root 2. So we have the distance as d is equal to root under y1 minus y2 guys, y1 minus y2 square that is 4 minus 6, 2, plus minus 1 by root 2, okay, square, right, 2 plus minus, 4 minus 6 minus, minus plus 1 by root 2, that is, 4 minus 6 is minus 2, it is minus 2, plus minus root half square, okay, plus 2, minus plus 1 by root 2 square which is equal to if you take minus as common then these two must be same so we have 2 minus plus 1 by root 2 square okay but this is the minimum distance so this is the minimum distance we have already found this is the minimum distance that is one distance is 2 minus 1 by root 2 and other distance is 2 plus 1 by root 2. So, d minimum is 2 minus 1 by root 2. Yes. And the point of contact, point on the parabola which is at the minimum distance is 2, 4. So, the question is asking, question is very simple. We have done a lot of things and brush out concepts. So, the question is very simple. The coordinates, question is only asking the coordinates of point of contact on parabola which is minimum distance. So, we have already found the coordinate. That coordinate is 2, 4. Okay. So we have seen different approaches for this question. So now move to the next question. Moving to the next question. Problem 5. So radius of the circle passing through the origin and touching the parabola 4ax at 1, 2. Okay. So we have a circle which is passing through origin and touching the parabola. So we have a parabola y square is equal to 4ax. Right, the parabola y square is equal to 4x. Here, this instead of 4x, the parabola is 4x, right, given in the question. So, we have focus at 1, 0, and this is the parabola y square is equal to 4x. And we have a circle such that it passes through origin, okay, and as well as touches this parabola at point 1, 2. Okay, so we have a circle. Which is somewhat like which passes through this as well. Okay, this is a circle. at point 1, 2, it touches the parabola. So we have a circle which passes through origin and touches the parabola somewhat at point 1, 2, like this. Okay, and we have to find the equation and we have to find the radius of that circle. Okay, so again we can write equation of normal at point 1, 2. Equation of normal at 1, 2. Okay. With respect to parabola, you can write the equation as y square is equal to, the equation of parabola is y square is equal to 4x, and the equation of tangent we can write as x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. Right? Because the equation of tangent is given as y plus tx is equal to at cube plus 2at, and here a is equal to 1. Okay, and the point is at square is equal to 1, 2at is equal to 2, so t is equal to 1. So we have the tangent as y plus x is equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3. So this is the equation, the equation of normal is, so this is the equation of normal. Let us assume the center of circle as HK. HK is the center of circle. So this line must pass through HK. So y plus x is equal to 3 must pass through HK, right? So we have h plus k is equal to 3, relation between h and k, right? Also, say the equation of circle we can write as say, suppose this is a circle which is passing through point 1, 2 and also passing through point origin, and here is a point HK. So we have this distance equal to this distance because both are radius, right? So we have h square plus k square, which is distance from origin, is equal to h minus 1 square plus k minus 2 square, right? Which is distance from point 1, 2. Or we have equation, if we expand this, then we will be getting h square plus k square minus 2h minus 4k plus 5, right? H square plus 1 minus 2h, and h k square minus 4k plus 4, which is 4 plus 1, 5. So we have the equation, or h square k square will get cancelled. So we have 2h plus 4k is equal to 5, second relation. So using these two relations, we can get 2h, h and k. That's to say, we are substituting the value of k from this equation, from this equation. Okay. So the value of k is 4. G minus h is equal to 5, or we have 2h plus 12 minus 4h is equal to 5, which is 2h minus 4h is, from here we will be getting h as 7 by 2, right, minus 2, and this is minus 7, so 7 by 2, and k as 3 minus 7 by 2, which is 6 by 2 minus 7 by 2, which is minus half. Okay. So we have the center of circle as 7 by 2 and minus half. So radius of the circle must be 7 by 2 square plus half square under root, as this point passes through the origin. So we have half under root 7 square plus 1 square, which is 50. Okay. So 50 can be written as 5 times 25 times 2, right? So 5 root 2. Okay, so 5 by root 2 is the radius. So from option, you can see that option C is the correct, right? Correct one. So now moving to the next question. we have a line 3x plus 2y is equal to 8 and an ellipse, which is the equation is given by x square plus 4y square is equal to 16, right? So we have to find the point of contact of that ellipse, point of contact of this line which is tangent to the ellipse, given ellipse, right? So first let us make this ellipse in the standard form, okay? So the equation of ellipse is 3x square plus 4y square is equal to 16, or we can write it as x square upon 16 y 3 plus y square upon 4 is equal to 1, right? Where a is 4 by root 3 and b is 2, because we have general equation of ellipse as x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. So from comparing these two equations, we will be getting a as 4 by root 3 and b as 2. And the line 3x plus 2y is equal to 8 is a tangent to this ellipse, right? It is not given whether this line is tangent or not. So, what is the condition of tangency? The condition of tangency to the ellipse is, the condition of tangency is somewhat, say the ellipse is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1 and y is equal to mx plus c is a tangent, then c must be equal to, c square must be equal to a square m square plus b square, right? So say this line, first let us check whether this line is a tangent or not. So we can write this line 3x plus 2y is equal to 8 in form y is equal to mx plus c. Writing this is in form y is equal to minus 3 by 2x plus 4. So we have m as minus 3 by 2 and c as 4. Checking this, whether it is satisfying this condition or not. C square is 16. A square is 16 by 3. M square is 9 by 4 plus b square is 4. So this is equal to 4, 4, 16, 3, 3, 9. This is 12 plus 4, which is equal to 16. So this is satisfying. That is, c square is equal to a square m square plus b square in this case. So this line is a tangent to the circle. We have verified it, right? This line is a tangent. Now finding the point of contact. The point of contacts are minus a square m upon c and b square upon c. Okay. So from here, minus a square m, a square is, here a is 4 by root 3, so a square is 16 by 9, okay. And what is the value of c? C is 4, so a square is 16 by 9, m is given by minus 3 by 2, okay, minus 3 by 2 and c is 4. So point of contact is 3, 3, 9 and 2. So x coordinate is minus 2 by 3, right? And y coordinate is b square upon c, so 4 upon 4, 1. So we have the point of contact of tangent on the ellipse. X is equal to 2, y is equal to b square upon c, and in our case a square upon, a square is 4 by 3, right? 16 by 3. So we have all, we have actually done some mistake here. So x coordinate of point of intersection is minus a square m upon c. Putting the value of, putting all the values correctly, we will be getting a square as 16 by 3, m as minus 3 by 2 and 4 C as 1 by 4. So, this is equal to 2. And y coordinate as V square upon C. V is 4 and C is 4, which is 1. So, we have point of contact as 2, 1. Right. So, our option here from here, option B is correct. Right. Now, moving to the next question. The length of major axis of ellipse. So, here we have a equation of ellipse as 5x minus 10 plus 5y plus 15 square is equal to 3x minus 4y plus 7 upon 4. Okay. So, let us see how this equation arises. So, we have a definition of ellipse. We have seen that our definition of ellipse is, we have a, say we have a fixed point and we have a fixed line and the ratio, and the point P is moving such that ratio from a fixed point and a fixed line is E, which is less than equal to 1, right? This is less than 1. So, here also the same case is there. The equation is written in that form only. The equation is written like 5x minus 10 square plus 5y plus 15 square is equal to 3x minus 4y plus 7 square upon 4. So, if we take 5 as common, then we will be getting x minus 2 square, okay, 25, plus here also y plus 3 square, 25 is equal to 3x minus 4y plus 7 square upon, if we write as like this, 3 square plus 4 square, okay, under root whole square into 3 square plus 4 square under root whole square upon 4, right? Or we have the equation as x minus 2 square plus y plus 3 square is equal to mod of 3x minus 4y plus 7 upon root 3 square plus 4 square whole square into, this value is 5, okay, so root this value is 5, so 5 square is 25, so 25 by 4 into 1 by 25, okay. So finally our equation is very simple, which is x minus 2 square plus y plus 3 square is equal to 3x minus 4y plus 7 upon 3 square plus 4 square under root and its modulus square into 1 by 4. So we have the focus as, our focus as 2 minus 3, right, directrix as line 3x minus 4y plus 7 and eccentricity E as 1 by 4. Okay. So, the question is asking length of major axis. Okay. Length of major axis. So, for an ellipse, say for an ellipse, say this is an ellipse where this is foci, these are the foci and these are the directrix. Okay. So that, say suppose we have an ellipse x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1 with this as major, x axis as major axis. So we have the length of major axis as 2 times a, right? Because this is a0, this is minus a0. So, 2 times a is the length of major axis. Okay. That means, the length of major axis is the distance of vertex and directrix and the distance of center of ellipse from the focus. Right.
isn't it? Okay, so we have the ellipse x minus 2 square plus y plus 3 square is equal to this mod of this number into 1 by 4. So we have already find our focus and eccentricity, right? So from our general definition, say this is a point of focus, this is focus, and say this is directrix, okay? And we have an ellipse like this, okay? So we can find the distance between focus and directrix, right? We can easily find this distance between focus and directrix, which is the length of perpendicular distance between this focus and directrix. Okay, which is the length of major axis, right? So we can find this length. We have a point focus as 2 minus 3 and directrix. This is focus. We have already written, and the directrix is this line. So we have a distance of this point from line as d is equal to 3 times 2 minus 4 times minus 3, which is 4 times 3 plus 7 upon 5, right? Which is equal to 6 plus 12 plus 7 upon 5, which is equal to 6 plus 12 is 18, 18 plus 7, 25 by 5, which is equal to 3, right? So this distance we have found as 3, and now we have to find the distance from center, okay? So this distance is AE, isn't it? Because the focus is, in this case focus is AE, so we have found this distance plus this distance. So this distance by 2 plus this distance is the length of major axis, right? So we have the length of major axis as 2 times A, right? See, say this is ellipse and this is directrix, and this is our focus. The coordinate of focus is minus AE 0. So this distance is AE, okay? And this distance is, suppose distance between this and directrix is L. So this is L by 2. So we have the length this as L by 2 plus AE, right? And 2 times this length is the length of major axis, that is L plus 2A. So we have already find that is L is equal to 5, right? And also we have this point A. So we can have A by E minus AE is equal to 5, or we have A as 5. So putting the value of E here, A by 2 minus 2A is equal to 5. So we have, from here we can find A is equal to 10 by 3, which is the length of major axis, right? This is A0. So the length of major axis length is 2 times this length, 2A, which is 20 by 3. So B is the correct option, right? So here we have to first change this equation in a form of definition of the ellipse. okay, so that you can get the focus and the directrix as well as eccentricity. Okay, so this is the concept here. Now moving to the next question. The distance of center of ellipse, this ellipse, from those tangents of ellipse which are equally inclined to the both axes. Okay, so we have an ellipse x square plus 2y square minus 2. Okay, so let us write this ellipse in standard form. X square plus 2y square is equal to 2, or we have x square by root 2 square plus y square by 1 square is equal to 1. So this is our ellipse, right? And we have to find the equation, distance of the center of ellipse from the tangents which are equally inclined to both axes. So let us write the equation of tangent on the ellipse. Say y is equal to mx plus c is the tangent to the ellipse, where c is equal to plus minus root under a square m square plus b square. So we can have c as plus minus a square, which is equal to 2 m square plus b square, which is equal to 1. So our equation of tangent is y is equal to mx plus minus root under 2 m square plus 1, right? This is our tangent. Okay, so this, it is given that the tangents are equally inclined, right? So m can be plus minus 1, that is theta is equal to either 45 degree or minus 45 degree. So we have m is equal to plus minus 1, right? So we can get tangents as y is equal to plus minus 1 plus minus y is equal to mx, which is plus minus x, m is 1, plus minus 2m square plus 1. 2m square means 2 plus 1, plus minus 3. So we have equation of tangent as, we have actually 4 tangents, which is y plus x is equal to root 3, y plus x is equal to minus root 3, y minus x is equal to root 3, and y minus x is equal to minus root 3. So if we draw these 4 tangents, 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are the 4 tangents. Okay, so we have to find the distance, either this distance or this distance, because these 2 distances are equal. Okay, so let us find the distance from center to the any of the tangents. Okay, because all those distances are equal. So let us take this tangent and find the distance of origin from this tangent. So the distance of origin is 0 plus 0 minus root 3 upon 1 square plus 1 square under root, right? So this distance is 3 upon 2 under root, right? So from our option, option D is correct one, right? Now moving to the next question. If line, given line root 3 plus bx plus ay, okay, is equal to 2ab, touches the ellipse x square plus y square, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, then the eccentric angle of the point of contact is, say, what is the eccentric angle? Say this is the ellipse, okay, and this is a tangent. So if we draw a circle whose radius is equal to a, say this is the point of contact of tangent, then this angle is eccentric angle. Okay, this angle given by this angle theta, the eccentric angle. So we have to find that angle. So let us write the equation of tangent in form x by something plus y by something is equal to, right, because we have equation in parametric form. Equation of tangent in parametric form, as x by x cos theta upon a plus y sin theta upon b is equal to 1, right? So here also, if we try to write the equation, above equation, that is root 3bx plus ay is equal to 2ab. Dividing it by 2ab both the side, we will be getting root 3x by 2a plus y by 2b is equal to 1. Or we have x by a into root 3 by 2 plus y by b into half is equal to 1. So from here, if you compare this and this equation, right, then from here we will be getting cos theta is equal to root 3 by 2 and sin theta is equal to half. That means theta must be 30 degrees. So our eccentric angle is 30 degrees, which is equal to pi by 6 radians. So we have pi by 6. Option A is correct. Now moving to the next question. The ellipse x square plus y square, x square upon a square plus y square upon b square meets the straight line this on x axis and the straight line this on y axis, then its eccentricity is. So we have a equation of ellipse as x square plus y square. X square upon a square, we have the equation of ellipse in general form, right? And we have two straight line x upon 7 plus x upon 7 plus y upon 2 is equal to 1. Okay. And x upon 3 minus y upon 5 is equal to 1. So the ellipse, the question is saying that the ellipse, if this given ellipse meets the straight line, meets this straight line on x axis and meets this straight line on y axis. Okay. So what is its eccentricity? Right. So let us found that. So we have the line x upon 7 plus y upon 7 is equal to 1, okay, which cuts x axis at 7, 0, right? And line, which line? X by 3 minus y by 5 is equal to 1 cut y axis at 0 minus 5. Okay. 0 minus 5. So ellipse must pass through this point. So we have two lines which are x by 7 plus y by 2. So this is y by 2. So this passes through x axis at x is equal to 7, because at x axis y is equal to 0, so x is equal to 7. And this passes through y axis at point 0 minus 5, because here x is equal to 0, so y is equal to minus 5. Now these two points satisfies the equation of ellipse, right? So our equation of ellipse is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. So first let us put 0.70. So from here, y is equal to 0, so x is equal to 7. 49 upon a square. We can write 49 upon a square plus 0 is equal to 1. Right? Or a square is equal to 49, a is equal to 7. Right? And this ellipse also passes through point 0 minus 5. So we have 0 plus 25 by b square is equal to 1. Okay. From here, we will be getting b is equal to 5. So, eccentricity of ellipse, we have a relation between b and a. That is, b square is equal to a square 1 minus e square. or we can say that b square is 25 and a square is 49, 1 minus a square. So from here 1 minus a square is 25 upon 49, or e square is 1 minus 25 upon 49, which is equal to 49 minus 25 is 24, right? 24 upon 49. So we have e as root under 24 upon 7. 24 is 12 times 6 times 4. So we have 2 root 6. The eccentricity is given by 2 root 6 upon 7, right? So we have 2 root 6 upon 7 eccentricity. So let us see which option matches 2 root 6 upon 7. So we have none of the option like 2 root 6 upon 7. So none of these is the correct option, because our eccentricity is coming as 2 root 6 upon 7. Okay. So moving to the next question, we have: if a sec theta, b tan theta, and a sec phi, b tan phi are the endpoints of focal chords of given hyperbola. So this is the equation of general hyperbola. Okay, and we have two points which is given in parametric form. That is a sec theta, b tan theta, and a sec phi, b tan phi. Okay, so it is asking the value of tan theta by 2 and tan phi by 2, times tan phi by 2. Okay. So we can write the equation of line which connects these two points, that is a sec theta, b tan theta, and a sec phi, b tan phi. So equation of line passing through these two points can be written as x upon a cos theta minus phi upon 2 minus y upon v sin theta minus phi upon 2 is equal to cos theta plus phi upon 2. Here it is cos theta plus phi upon 2. This is also known as the equation of connecting chords, okay, in hyperbola, right? So if this point passes through this line passes through point AE0, right? Because this is a focal chord, these are the in point of focal chords. So we have this as a equation of focal chord. This is nothing but equation of focal chord. So since this is a equation of focal chord, so it must pass through the point AE0, right? So if it passes through the point AE0, we have putting x as AE and y as 0, we will be getting e cos theta minus phi upon 2, right, is equal to cos theta plus phi upon 2, right? Okay, so we have e as cos theta plus phi upon 2 upon cos theta minus phi upon 2, right? Now we will be doing some trigonometric, we will be expanding these two. Okay, while expanding these two, we will be getting cos theta by 2 cos phi by 2 minus sin theta by 2 sin phi by 2. Okay, and here cos theta by 2 cos phi by 2 plus sin theta by 2 sin phi by 2. So if we divide numerator as well as denominator by cos theta by 2 cos phi by 2, then we will be getting e is equal to 1 minus tan theta by 2 tan phi by 2 upon 1 plus tan theta by 2 tan phi by 2. Okay, from here we will be getting 1 plus tan theta by 2 tan pi by 2 times E, okay, is equal to 1 minus tan theta by 2 tan pi by 2. So we have taking tan theta by 2 tan pi by 2 common from these both sides, we will be getting tan theta by 2 tan pi by 2 times E minus 1 is equal to 1 minus E, right? Actually, this is, if you take this as this side, if you take this quantity on this side, then we will be getting 1 plus E, and here it is 1 minus E. So we have tan theta by 2 into tan pi by 2 as 1 minus E upon 1 plus E. So option B is, so from here you can see that 1 minus E upon 1 plus E, that is option B is correct one, right? So now moving to the next question, the equation of hyperbola whose foci are 6, 5, minus 4, 5 and eccentricity is 5 by 4. So we have foci as 6, 5 and minus 4, 5 and eccentricity as 5 by 4, right? So we have to find the equation of hyperbola whose foci as well as eccentricities are known, right? So let us find say this is the hyperbola, okay, whose foci are something here and here, which are AE0 and minus AE0. In case of standard equation, whose equation is x square upon a square minus y square upon b square is equal to 1, okay, right? So we have, say this is S1, this is S2. So we have S1 as 6, 5 and S2 as say minus 4, 5. Okay. And it is given E as 5 by 4. So distance between S1 and S2 can be written as 5 minus 5 square plus 6 plus 4 square under root, which is equal to 10. Right. So this distance can be written as 2AE, which is equal to 10, isn't it? Or AE can be written as 10 by 2, which is 5. Okay. And we have E as 5 by 4. So A is 5 into 4 by 5, which is equal to 4. So now we have the value of A with us. And B can be we can easily find B as root under A square, E square minus 1. So A is 4 and A is 5 by 4. So 5 by 4 minus 1 is 25 minus 16 by 16 root under. Okay. Which is equal to 25 minus 16, 9. So 3 upon 4. So B is 3. Right. And we have the center of curve, center of curve is 1, 5, because the points foci are 6, 5 and minus 4, 5. So midpoint of this is 6 minus 4 upon 2, which is equal to 1, and 5 minus 5 plus 5 upon 2, which is equal to 5. So this is the center of our hyperbola. So we have the equation of hyperbola as x minus 1 square upon a square, which is equal to 16, plus y minus 5 square upon b square, which is equal to 9, is equal to 1. So this is the equation of hyperbola. So from here you can see that option A is the correct one, right? Since this is hyperbola, so this shouldn't be plus, this should be minus. Okay. Now moving to the next question. If the lattice rectum sustains right angle at center of hyperbola, then its eccentricity is. Okay. So we have to find the eccentricity of the hyperbola such that its lattice rectum sustains right angle. Okay. So we have, say this is our hyperbola. Okay. And this is its foci. So this is its lattice rectum. And this is the center of hyperbola. So lattice rectum sustains right angle at the center. That means this is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. So we have to find the eccentricity. Okay. So this is point A. This is center O, and this is say point B. So we can write, and say this is point C. So we can write angle AOC as 45 degree, right? Or we can have OA which is equal to OB, isn't it? And since this angle is 45 degree, so we have OA is equal to OB is equal to AC is equal to BC as well, right? So we have AE is equal to B square upon A, right? Or E is equal to E square minus 1, isn't it? Because B square we can write as A square E square minus 1. So we have this relation. Okay. So our E is equal to, from here we can solve the quadratic equation, and we found that E is equal to root 5 plus 1 upon 2. So from here option C is correct one. Right. Okay. Moving to the next question, we have the point on hyperbola which is nearest to the line x3x plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0, right? So to find a point on hyperbola x square minus 2 x square upon 24 minus y square upon 18 is equal to 1, okay? And there is a line 3x plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so suppose say this is our hyperbola, okay, and say this is a line. This is a line, okay. So this line does not intersect, because if it intersects this hyperbola, then the minimum distance and then the point of intersection is the point of intersection is the nearest to the line, given line 3x plus 2y plus 1, right? Point of intersection of hyperbola and the line is the nearest point. So suppose this line does not intersect, so this is the most tough case, right? So we have a line which is tangent to this hyperbola, okay, and this point on hyperbola, right, is at the nearest with this line, isn't it? So we have to find this point. So we have equation of tangent in say parametric form. Okay, let us write the equation of tangent in parametric form, and we will be equating the slope of that tangent with this line, so that these two lines are parallel, right? Okay, so we have here, from here we have A as root 24, which is equal to 24 is 4 times 6, which is equal to 2 root 6, right? And B is equal to root under 18. Okay, root under 18, which is equal to 3 root 2. So we have equation of tangent at point A sec theta B tan theta. Okay, as we can write equation of tangent as x sec theta upon A, which is root under 24 minus y tan theta upon B, which is root under 18, is equal to 1. Okay, and from the equation of line 3x plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0, we have a slope of line as y is equal to minus 3 by 2 x minus half. So from here m is equal to minus 3 by 2, right? And from here the slope is y tan theta upon root 18, okay, is equal to x sec theta upon root 24 plus 1. It is actually minus 1. Okay, taking this side, taking y tan theta this side, we will be getting this equation. So y can be written as 18 upon 24 root under sec theta upon tan theta, right? Sec theta is 1 by cos theta, tan theta is sin theta by cos theta. So this is equal to 18 by 24 into 1 by sin theta. Okay, so this is the slope. So this slope must be equal to that slope, which is m is equal to minus 3 by 2. So we have 18 upon 24 as 6, 3 by 18, 6, 4 the 24. So 3 by root 3 by 2, right, into sin theta is equal to minus 3 by 2. So this is root 3 and this cancels. Okay. This is 1 by sin theta, right? So we have sin theta is minus 1 by root 3, right? Sin theta is minus 1 by root 3. So we have sec theta. We can find, since sin theta is minus 1 by root 3, so we can find the value of sec theta and tan theta. Sec theta and tan theta. And we will be substituting these values on point A sec theta, B tan theta to get the point of nearest approach. So if we substitute that, the value of sin theta on both two, we will be getting point as A sec theta, which is equal to A is root 24 sec theta, which is equal to 6, and B tan theta, which is equal to root under 18 tan theta, which is equal to, from here sin theta, putting the values here tan theta, which we will be getting minus 3. So 6 minus 3 is a point. So from here you can see that option C is correct. Now moving to the next question. The common tangent to 9x square minus 16y square is equal to 144 and x square plus y square is equal to 9 is. See, here there is a hyperbola and a circle. So we have to find the equation of a line which is tangent to both these curves as well as hyperbola and this circle. Okay. So we have a hyperbola in standard form as x square upon 16 minus y square upon 9 is equal to 1, or we can write it as x square upon 4 square minus y square upon 3 square is equal to 1. So here a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 3, right? And the equation of circle is x square plus y square is equal to 9, right? So from here x square plus y square is equal to 3 square. So we have to find the equation of common tangent, right? So let us say y is equal to mx plus c is a common tangent, right? So from condition y is equal to mx plus c is a tangent to circle, okay, x square plus y square is equal to a square, we have c square is equal to a square m square plus a square, that is c square is equal to a square is 3 square, which is 9, m square plus 9. So this is, let's call it equation 1. And from the condition y is equal to mx plus c is a tangent to hyperbola x square upon a square minus y square upon v square is equal to 1. C square is equal to a square m square minus b square. So from here we will be getting c square as a square. In case of our hyperbola a is 4. So 16 m square and b is 3. So 9. 16 m square minus 9. Right? So from 1 and 2 we can write 9 m square plus 9 is equal to 16 m square minus 9, or we have 7 m square is equal to 18, right? 7 m square is equal to 18, 16 minus 9 which is 7, and 9 plus 9 is equal to 18, or m is equal to 18 by 7 root plus minus. It can be plus or it can be minus. So we have the equation of tangent as y is equal to mx, that is plus minus root 18 by 7 x, and c is m square plus 1 under root plus minus a. A is, where a is 3, so plus minus 3 m square plus 1 under root. So m square is 18 by 7, so 18 plus 7 by 7, okay, right? So 18, 25 by 7, so it is plus minus 15 by root 7, okay? So we have equation as y is equal to plus minus 18 by, under root 18 by 7, x plus minus 15 by 7, okay? So if we see, we try to match the option. So 18 by 7 can be written as 3 root 2 by 7, right? Okay. So from here, option B is the correct one. Okay. Because option B is only matching the equation, form of the equation. So option B is correct. So this is the last question we have done. So now the topic coordinate geometry, we have solved most of the problems and we have done lot of practice, and lot of practice is also required, okay, so by you students. So next we will be moving on 3-dimensional coordinate geometry, right, and vector, okay. So this is the end of the lecture. Thank you.